Hi, I'm Daniel Winfield-Smith. I'm here at Comic-Con New York, and we're here to talk about Thief. I'm the lead level designer for Eidos Montréal.
Let's start from a big picture perspective of what the experience will be like for PC gamers that buy Thief.
So PC is very important for us. The experience needs to be really crisp. We have, audio is a good example. It's really important that the audio experience is really there. You know, you disable all that UI input, and you just purely focus on, your surroundings, and you hear guards, their footsteps, their barks, they talk around you, and you just kind of have to live into that experience, that immersion.
When it comes to sound, can you talk a little bit more in depth in terms of how that impacts the actual gameplay experience for PC gamers that have the true sound, true audio?
So in terms of gameplay for the audio, there's a lot of surface types that kind of differentiate whether or not if you're running on them, if you're walking on them, you're crouching on them. They make different, different kind of sounds. So we want to make sure that the player understands what's going on. If they step on broken glass, that they hear the cracks, and they understand that the AI is going to react to that, and they kind of have to adapt to that situation. So audio is a very important, and it's always been an important part for the Thief franchise.
When it comes to the visual experience, can you give us a sense of the PC and what that opens up from people being able to see your creation with all those sliders rolled all the way up?
So for the PC gamer, you can really crank up the graphics, all the texture, the crispness. There's a lot of special effects that our tech departments are just pumping out everything they can to just make sure that the experience is as immersive as it possibly can be. So our technicians have worked really hard with AMD to really maximize and optimize for PC gamers.
Let's talk a little bit about what's new when it comes to Thief. What are you guys revealing here at Comic-Con?
So we don't want to change too much. We really want to keep that essence of the Thief franchise. We added some things, like we have the focus that kind of enables players to be able to enhance certain abilities. This is, of course, something you can disable if you're more of the old school fan. You can just disable it and play as you would play the original series. So that's something, but we really want to focus on a great story, a great single player, and really make you be immersed in this.
But in terms of here at Comic-Con, what have you guys revealed at the panels and stuff? Tell us a little bit about what's new. The last time we talked to you guys was back at E3.
So we have the City Hub, which is a new, it's not new, but it's something we revealed this week. And it's about the open world aspect of it, of you running around in the city where you can, you can burglarize people if you want to. That's kind of up to the player. Or you can go around, you can meet Basso, you can go upgrade your gear, you can buy arrows, you can just explore. And it's kind of this more like you take things at your own pacing and you kind of explore. Maybe you'll find secrets, you'll find things that happen in the city. You kind of maybe there's an opportunity there and you kind of go with it.
When it comes to the gameplay, how do you differentiate as a gamer what they can do just for fun in that open world versus what they're doing through missions?
So there's a very strong narrative that kind of drives you to go in a certain direction. And for players who just want to have that narrative, the good story, you just go with it, go along with it. But nothing stops you from just taking a right turn and just going that direction and kind of improvising on it. And if they want to return to the mission, they just go back into that direction where they were guided to before.
Can you talk a little about how advances in technology have opened up new stealth gameplay for Thief?
So immersion is a very important part for us. So stealth gameplay has become much more about reading the environments, reading about what's going on. The AI has much more blending with the animation. They have better head tracking and more adaptive sensory systems. And that's the kind of thing that comes along with having more CPU power and so on.